Thank you. Good morning. Can everybody hear me okay in the back? So I'm not going to use the mic or whatever. All right, given the choice between laundry detergents, would you choose a detergent that got your clothes super clean, like your whites the whitest, or would you choose a detergent that made your clothes smell fantastic? The popular choice might surprise you. Over the past year and a half, I've been traveling back and forth to Ireland. My partner lives in Ireland, and she can't come here due to this whole, you know, COVID scenario. So I've spent a lot of time going to Ireland. And one of the last Airbnbs I stayed at had this laundry detergent that made my clothes smell awesome. So much so that complete strangers actually complimented me on how nice they smelled. And it feels pretty good to get a compliment from a complete stranger, right? So this got me thinking about laundry detergent and laundry detergent manufacturers. So I did a bunch of research, and one of the leading laundry detergent manufacturers spent millions and millions and millions of dollars trying to come up with a formula to make clothes that were washed with their detergent cleaner than all of their competitors. And they succeeded with this new formula after much time, effort, and cost. And when they unveiled this new formula to the world, guess what happened? Not much. It turns out people don't really care about how clean their clothes get. They care about how nice their clothes smell. So the laundry detergent industry, that manufacturer, was focused on the wrong thing. And I think in leadership and in my industry, cybersecurity, so some of my stories will be about cybersecurity, but in leadership as well, we tend to focus on the wrong things, just like the laundry detergent industry. We tend to focus on the data-rich tangibles, you know, better technology, key performance indicators, revenue, are we meeting our SMART goals, are we meeting our outcomes? And this often comes at the expense of a human-rich experience. How people feel is really just as important as the data. And if people feel better during their jobs, they're going to be more productive anyway. For me, about 5 years ago, sort of my defining moment was with my company. One of my highly technical engineers, super bright, was giving me a debrief about how a penetration test report review session went with a client. A penetration test is basically where we're hired to hack into someone's environment. He kept telling me that the client just didn't get it, meaning the client did not understand what we were telling them, the severity of what we found, nor did they understand how to fix the issues we identified. And for some reason, this struck me very differently this time. I'd heard variations of "they just don't get it" most of my career, but this time it struck me differently. Probably because this was my company, and I put my life savings in the company, and I wanted my clients to get it. So I had more skin in the game. And what I realized when I looked back over my career and connected the dots, and my career was, you know, Air Force, DoD contractor, freelancer, I pretty much have done a little bit of everything. When I connected the dots, I realized that poor leadership, intellectual bullying, and posturing is where you pretend you know something but you really don't, are really inhibiting us. And they were inhibiting my company. And this shows up in various ways. It shows up with the phrase, "they just don't get it." It shows up with things when people say management just doesn't understand. It also shows up with managers that kiss up but kick down. You've probably experienced some of those. So now that I became aware of this, I thought, why should I care about this? One of the driving factors is necessity. Necessity is like the mother of invention, right? And with me, since this is my company, I had the necessity. I had to figure things out. And my job, our mission, was to help secure our clients. I didn't start a company to make people worse after dealing with us than better, right? And my clients needed to get it in order to be secure. I also, with a business purpose is to generate revenue, not lose money. If my clients aren't getting it, or if they're feeling unappreciated and misunderstood, they'll probably go somewhere else. And then when I pulled back the curtain a little bit, I realized that this problem was not just between my staff and clients, it was also internal. A lot of my staff were hesitant to make a suggestion, ask a question, or admit they didn't know something for fear of being ridiculed by a fellow staff member or their supervisor or someone that even works for them. So this is a challenge that I needed to solve. And I thought, you know, why should I care, but why should you care about this topic? I think what we're doing as leadership is marginally working. There's a lot of improvement we can make in leadership.